Of those 64 folks, 9 were so bad behind the wheel, they never learned enough to graduate from our educational facility. And it's these 9 people that you've been demanding to see again. So, crud! This year at the rehab center, we're bringing back the 9 most appalling drivers we have ever had to see which one of them is the most dangerous. And we're calling this extraordinary experiment Canada's Worst Driver Ever. Do you remember these folks? I do. In fact, these people haunt my dreams because... One of those 9 people is Canada's worst driver ever. Is it Chris? Canada's worst driver from season 1?
Son of a motherless goat.
Is it Henrietta? Canada's worst driver from season 2?
I want to quit this.
Maybe Canada's worst driver ever is Michael from season 2.
Wrong flipping gear.
Many people believe Shelby from season 3 is Canada's worst driver ever.
I am having issues with vehicle control.
But if you ask me, Angelina from season 5 should get the unwanted title.
There's no wheel! I don't even think there's a ramp!
Then, of course, there's Dale from season 6.
I just learned how to text!
And Shirley from season 7.
Damn it.
And Sly from season 7. And again, perhaps Kevin, Canada's worst driver from season 8, is in fact Canada's worst driver ever. The identity of Canada's worst driver ever will be revealed 8 episodes from now.
Oh, my God.
In order for our experts to decide who most deserves that unwanted title, the 9 nominees will be at our Driver Rehabilitation Center getting thoroughly tested on a series of 22 driving challenges.
That was scary.
Will any of these folks find redemption as a graduate of our rehab center? And more importantly, which one of them will end up with the embarrassing title, Canada's Worst Driver Ever?
This is so depressing!
Before your rehabilitation can start, you're going to have to get yourself to the rehab center. And to do that, you just need to follow the directions that are in these envelopes.
This year, the Driver Rehabilitation Center is located, once again, in the Dunnville, Ontario Airport. And to get there from where they are now should take the bad drivers a little over an hour. They'll have to go along a highway, through a tunnel, and across some train tracks. And Michael will be the first to go.
It's you, buddy. Let's get out of here.
When we met Michael in West Vancouver 7 years ago, he was nominated as Canada's worst driver by his best friend, Eric, who was especially concerned for Michael's safety.
Michael.
Whenever Michael had to drive through a tunnel.
Michael.
That's because in tunnels, Michael had a dizzying habit.
Okay.
When I go through a tunnel, I have to hold my breath because I can't convince myself to breathe.
Eric won't be with Michael when he gets to rehab this year. Eric's having a little bit of a health problem. So, Michael will be driving with Yolanda, his friend Eric's wife.
He was almost killed in the car accident back in March.
He was almost killed?
Yes.
Wait. You were almost killed in a car accident?
I was entirely unharmed in an accident.
That was your fault?
Yes, it was.
Michael fell asleep at the wheel while driving 100K an hour.
My car skipped off a culvert, across the ditch, and through the brush on the other side, so I came to a relatively gradual stop.
Were you going to be Canada's worst driver ever?
I sincerely hope not to be.
See you, Michael. Drive really, really safe. And so begins another year of Canada's worst driver.
en route to rehab.
That was kind of sort of going through a stop sign.
Yolanda's negativity isn't helping Michael.
Don't kill me and my kids and the mother.
Oh, you do such wonders for my confidence.
The next Canada's Worst Driver Ever nominee to hit the road to rehab will be Dale.
All right, Dale, let's go.
Okay.
When we met Dale in St. Catharines, Ontario, 3 years ago, she had a dubious honor.
You know, there's a stop sign there.
Yeah?
Dale had been nominated as Canada's Worst Driver by more people than any other candidate ever.
My name is John.
Linda.
Trevor.
Sam.
Amanda.
Greg. And I nominated my neighbor Dale as Canada's Worst Driver.
Dale says she's improved since those days.
What's that mean? Is somebody playing football?
But when we caught up with her just a few weeks ago...
200 milliliters.
That's 200 meters.
Oh, meters.
It all felt eerily familiar.
My name is Liz. Amanda.
Chris.
Greg.
John.
Danny.
And I've nominated my Aunt Dale as Canada's Worst Driver.
Are you a good enough driver now that your family drives with you?
My family doesn't drive with me.
They refuse?
Yeah.
Danny has agreed to drive with Dale just for her rehab experience.
Why are you stopping on a green light?
Oh, I don't know.
Back at the junkyard.
Shelby, you ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's make it happen, my friend.
My favorite driving student ever.
Hop on in, Shelby.
All right.
Will be the next to leave. When we met Shelby 6 years ago in Calgary...
I drive like a grandpa.
He was too afraid to drive the speed limit.
I don't want to go 50.
En route to rehab today...
Slow it back down to 80, please.
Shelby's brother, Ellerick, is wishing Shelby's slowpoke tendencies would return.
Dude, it's a 50 zone. You're doing 70.
Back at the junkyard.
Let's get out of here, Henrietta.
Henrietta will be the next Canada's Worst Driver to hit the road.
Since being at the rehab center, any accidents?
No, no.
No?
No.
Why is that?
Because I don't drive. He does all the driving for me.
He is Andy, Henrietta's husband.
So is this like a life sentence for you, Andy, or what?
Yes.
No. It's a life sentence.
It is a life sentence, yes.
When we first met this Maritimer, she often didn't see things as obvious as yellow center lines.
Andrew, I want to quit this.
These days, the only thing that seems different about Henrietta is her hair color.
Oh.
Just went through a stop sign.
When we come back...
Stop, stop.
The rest of Canada's worst drivers ever hit the road to rehab.
Watch out. Truck.
What?
Truck.
Oh, that truck.
Four nominees for the unwanted title, Canada's Worst Driver Ever.
What a funny road, look.
It's a tunnel, dude.
Are on the road to rehab.
Michael, breathe. Michael.
The remaining five nominees are still waiting for their turn to leave.
Ready to go and do this?
Sure. Let's go for a road trip.
Sly from season 7 is returning to rehab with Fred, his brother-in-law.
You wouldn't let your kids ride with him when I first met you.
Correct.
And that's still true?
That's still true.
When we met Sly in Lethbridge, Alberta 2 years ago, using his cell phone and eating and drinking while driving was commonplace for him. But after completely losing control in our distracted driving demonstration, Sly made this potentially life-saving promise.
Promise me you'll never eat a sandwich while driving again.
Yeah, I know I won't.
You'll never use your cell phone while driving again.
No.
Now Sly lives in Red Deer, Alberta.
Oh, crap.
And his habit of driving with massive amounts of food and drink in his hands...
See, this is a little easier to eat.
What's easier to eat?
Chicken strip.
Seems to have intensified.
This one time, I was very hungry. Blood sugar was very low. I actually did hit somebody, you know, because I was very hungry.
Driving to our rehab center today...
I'm a slow thinker.
Sly is headed for trouble.
I might have to go through a drive-thru on the way. I'm getting hungry.
Kevin will be the next to leave.
About time.
Kevin was named Canada's worst driver just last year.
You were in a serious accident since leaving the rehab center last time, hey?
The day after season 8 premiered, yes. I came down a little hill, I slid sideways.
And he ended up in the ditch, where he got injuries that include...
whiplash to the upper neck, muscle damage to my lower back, and tailbone injury.
And physically, how are you now?
Physically, I'm about 90%.
Visually, though, this native of McBride, B.C. is only 50%.
I'm permanently blind in the right eye.
Having a right eye made of glass is something that deeply concerns Lenny, Kevin's boyfriend.
Watch out. Truck.
What? Truck. Oh, that truck.
Back at the junkyard, Cape Breton's finest will leave next.
I want hugs first. Oh. Show me the money, baby.
Shirley was Canada's worst driver 2 years ago, but she says she's not anymore.
The rehab center totally changed her life.
Totally.
Shirley's daughter, Janice, totally agrees.
Is she going to be Canada's worst driver ever?
Definitely not. Like, she's going to be one of the first graduates.
2 years ago in Halifax, Shirley drove like this.
Am I going over there?
Yes. Go! Quick! Drive!
And this is Shirley driving in Halifax now.
Oh, Janice, I'm just elated that I can do this.
The secret to Shirley's success is pretty simple.
I was fascinated with the whole thing of learning to become a better driver.
Shirley has been diligently taking extra driving lessons. Headed to our rehab center today. Shirley's still confused in intersections.
Stop, stop. Why did you do that?
I wasn't paying attention.
Only two drivers are left at the junkyard. And one of them doesn't want to drive. Angelina says she's too hungover to take the wheel today.
Hey, I'm all about you not driving. If you don't want to drive, I'm all for that.
Oh, I still drive, but
you
just don't want to drive right now.
Fine.
Stinking of booze on the morning you're supposed to drive yourself to rehab is an outlandishly irresponsible way to start this season. But at least Angelina's acknowledging how dangerous she is.
I like that you're turning a new leaf and you don't want to drive. I think this is a wise choice.
Luckily, Chris has agreed to take her to rehab. Chris was the first ever Canada's worst driver.
How was that for you?
Well, I mean, appropriate for the time, but not anymore.
When we met Chris in season one, he had almost no experience behind the wheel. 8 years later, though, Chris is driving like a veteran.
Oh, right now it's relatively rudimentary.
Today, I'm glad Chris is driving Angelina to rehab. Because in rehab, 4 years ago, Angelina failed more challenges than any student we've ever had.
Oh, my God! That was the worst thing ever!
And on the streets of Sudbury, she spent more time doing her makeup than paying attention to road rules.
I'm a multitasker.
When we visited her there again just a few weeks ago, Angelina's best friend, Christine, told us nothing has changed.
She still is Canada's worst driver. She was then, is now.
Angelina's not just a terror on the roads.
Hey, Mom.
She's a terror in her own garage. Oh! When we come back, Canada's worst drivers ever arrive at rehab. The worst drivers we've ever had on our show that's called Canada's Worst Driver are returning to our rehab center to find out which one of them is Canada's worst driver ever.
You could have went.
Last time I did that, I got hit by an 18-wheeler.
And the first to arrive at rehab...
The sign's at rehab center, so it is the rehab center.
...is Shelby. A former slowpoke.
Shelby, baby! Hey, how's it going?
Good. How's it going, Andrew?
Perfect, man.
Hey.
Welcome back to the rehab center.
Nice.
You know what's going to happen now, right?
Yeah.
What's going to happen now?
I have to give you my license.
Mm-hmm. All right, thanks, man. I think you're going to graduate really fast.
All right. Okay, perfect. Thanks.
The next driver to arrive is Michael, who's illegally wearing Bluetooth earbuds.
The only thing I use them for is answering phone calls.
Why talk on the phone when driving at all?
Well, actually, I just use this to quickly answer. I don't even place calls. I occasionally get them. Hello? Yeah. Oh, shut up. Because sometimes believe it or not, I have actually received junk phone calls on my cell.
It's a crazy world we live in here in the future.
Yeah.
You know what happens now at this stage of the show.
Oh, yes. What happens? I've seen enough.
Thank you very much.
Dale is the next person to approach the rehab center.
I've improved. I have. Not like the way I speak, but I've improved.
If Dale has improved, standing on her parking barrier should be safe for me.
Just don't hit it, because I'm standing up. Well, you hit it. Now you... Just pull the park...
Pull the parking barrier.
Dale, stop.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Henrietta has driven almost 100 kilometers today, and that's the longest drive she's done in years.
Do you even want to get that back?
Yes, definitely, in the next 2 days.
I don't think Sly will be graduating in the next 2 days.
How many sides is a stop sign, anyway?
How many sides is a stop sign?
Yes.
For real?
Is that five sides?
On a stop sign.
Stop. Well, it's not. I'm trying to think here.
I think Sly should kiss his license goodbye.
I'll say goodbye.
Thank you for this.
Shirley arrives next.
Yay! We're here, Janice!
Which means I am gonna get a hug.
These are fun.
And right behind Shirley...
I notice that you're weaving a lot, Kevin.
...is one-eyed Kevin, who this year is bravely putting his license on the line.
If I fail this year in driver rehab, I have vowed to not only turn in my license, but I will also sell my car.
That means the last car to arrive...
That was the best drive I've ever had to rehab.
...belongs to Chris, Canada's first worst driver.
Canada's worst driver no more.
I don't think so.
Chris seems to now be an average driver. The woman Chris delivered to rehab today, though, is far from average.
Hello.
Oh, yes.
Angelina was too hungover to drive today. And I hope she never drives again.
You really want me to quit? No. And the more you say it, the more I'm like, I'm driving just to spite you.
When we come back, we'll reassess the skill levels of Canada's worst drivers ever.
To find out who is Canada's worst driver ever, we're going to start off just like we always do, with an assessment challenge. We're going to see how well the candidates can handle a vehicle in tight spaces, how well they can reverse, and how well they can go forward at 50 kilometers an hour. And to do it, they're going to be using... No, you're kidding. That... To do it, they're going to be using... That car!
That car is a 2011 Camaro SS. It's got over 400 horsepower. It's got a V8 engine. And it's got a speedometer that goes up to 300. The first challenge our Camaro will be used for is our annual assessment challenge. It starts with a simple reverse that goes around one bend through a hallway of rims. Then, drivers must get the vehicle turned around in this concrete area before they have to gear up to 50 kilometers an hour for a simple slalom run. And that's it. I'll show you how easy it is.
The assessment challenge starts with a fairly simple short reverse.
Using my side mirrors, I go straight back to the sharp turn in the road, where to get through cleanly, drivers have to slightly reposition themselves with an S-turn.
Use your mirrors, folks. That's how you get around these tight spaces.
Once I get through the rims and enter the concrete section, I have to get turned around.
This is going to involve a little bit of inching back and forth, and back and forth inching is fine.
In fact, it's the only way to get the car turned around in this confined space.
Holy tight.
Once I do get turned around, I head for the exit. And when I squeeze through it,
yeah, baby,
it's time for the slalom.
Wow, this thing gets to 50 fast. There she is. Whoa. Light touch. Don't stare at the things you want to avoid. Stare at the space you want to go. And that is how you do that. Piece of cake.
Yeah.
Sometimes my job is fun.
Watching every move that Canada's worst drivers ever make will be our panel of experts.
It's okay to adjust your mirrors for certain situations. I mean, that's what driving is all about, making common sense decisions.
Tim Danter is our head driving instructor. Shamala Kiru is our resident psychologist. Philippe Letourneau is our high-performance driving instructor. And as always, the big man on campus is Cam Woolley, a former highway patrolman who now sits as our legal expert.
Distracted driving is now the number one cause of crashes in Canada.
The first bad driver to run the course is Canada's worst driver from season 5, Angelina, who's wearing high-heeled wedges.
I can do this, I can do this, I can do this.
And so begins this year at the Rehab Center here at Canada's Worst Driver Ever. Is Canada's Worst Driver Ever behind the wheel already?
I think so.
I think Angelina is one of the most clueless drivers I've ever met in my life.
Oh, what the
f***? Mirrors, right, Angelina? You're using your mirrors?
Yeah.
Mirrors.
I am.
No, she's not.
Sorry.
Do you need your mirrors lower? Like, can you see?
I can see out of the mirrors. I can see, guys.
If Angelina can see, why isn't she stopping before she's hitting?
Your backing up is what's going to kill you.
I'm sweating. I can't take it.
Listen to me. You gotta get your car in a different position. See? You gotta get your car over here more.
Instead of getting her car over there more, Angelina plows her way into the concrete section where she's still not using her mirrors. Getting turned around.
Oh.
Angelina ruins the Camaro's new paint job. On our slalom course,
you can do it. Just focus.
Angelina's going to learn that high-heeled wedges can get wedged.
Holy Wait. Now my foot got stuck between. My foot got stuck between the things.
Angelina's footwear is one of her many driving problems.
Was that okay?
Dale is up next.
Okay, how am I doing?
You haven't really moved.
When Dale does move, it becomes clear that she has no idea where she's going.
But is that a turn?
In the turnaround section, Dale is once again confused.
Is there something under the wheel?
Yeah, there's something under the wheel. What do you think is under your wheel? You think it's this?
Probably.
Leaving the turnaround area, Dale hits.
Almost.
And runs, which is something she's done a lot of in real life, too. Dale failed all three elements.
I think I half passed.
Half passed?
You found that.
But not the swallow.
You hit a person.
Last year's worst driver, Kevin, would often look forwards while driving backwards.
You're looking forward again.
Yeah, because I was looking at this stack.
Yeah, don't look forward, Kevin.
Okay. The whole course is that way, Kevin. Look beside you.
Oh, shoot.
Kevin's not using his side mirrors. He's not respecting front end swing.
Front end.
And he's not using S-turns to reposition himself.
Look at all the room over here, Kevin. Look at the room.
I'm kind of multitasking here, Andrew.
What are you doing, your taxes while you're driving?
20 minutes into Kevin's run.
Shoot.
He's still driving without looking.
If I was using my mirror, would I be able to look in my mirror, look straight down the line, and then see that? Yes, I would be able to.
In the turnaround section.
Okay, we're in.
I get Lenny out of the car.
I'm hopping out.
And we watch Kevin squish the front bumper. And then nearly rip it off.
Like, I'll be perfectly honest, I would be very surprised if he does not make final three.
I would be too.
Yeah.
He's hitting me right.
Yeah.
Kevin knows that to slalom successfully, you must
look where you want to go.
But instead of doing that, Kevin stares at the obstacles he's trying to avoid.
His eyes are not where they should be.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
This could be the beginning of the end of Kevin's entire driving career.
If I am named Canada's worst driver ever, not only have I vowed to hang up my keys permanently, but also sell my car.
Before Henrietta begins, I ask her to count the obstacles she hits.
One. Son of a bee.
Then she hits a second one, which of course leads to
three.
Then it's four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and just wait for it. 10.
How do you do this? How do you get that around there?
How can someone who drives every day not know how to reverse around a corner?
All the way to the right and as far as you can.
Before Henrietta comes unglued.
And now to your left.
I coach her through the corner.
Andrew, you're
okay, just keep on slowly like that.
In the turnaround section.
Oh, Andy.
Andy has to coach her through.
Keep going right.
And even with constant coaching.
Left turn, hard, left.
Henrietta is clearly out of her element.
I can't do this.
You're almost through.
She can't do the 50K an hour slalom either. It turns out Henrietta came back to rehab because she's no longer a driver.
I wanted to learn more driving skills because I don't want to have to do all the driving, which I do right now.
When we come back, the rest of Canada's worst drivers ever have their skills reassessed. Canada's worst drivers ever have been going through our reassessment course with some pretty disheartening results.
Listen to me.
Up next is Chris, who will have me as his passenger. On the simple reverse lane...
This is looking not bad so far.
Chris drives perfectly. In the turnaround section, Chris drives... Not perfect.
No.
And in the slalom, Chris drives absolutely perfectly.
Piece of cake.
So far, Chris is easily the best driver here.
I don't think you're Canada's worst driver ever.
I don't think so either.
When Sly reverses towards the turn, he drifts to the outside edge.
This calls for an S-turn.
Hey!
Do you remember the S-turn?
Well, Fred's Diddy.
Fred's S-turn Diddy went like this.
All the way to the right. All the way to the left.
Using Fred's S-turn Diddy today.
All the way to the right. All the way to the left.
Sly isn't moving the car while steering and singing.
All the way to the right. All the way to the left.
So to review, Sly started here. He came about two car lengths to here, and then one more to here. How long would it take you to drive three car lengths? For Sly, 25 minutes. How's it going so far, Sly?
Going slowly.
Slowly, yeah. That's correct. It's going slowly.
When Sly finally hones in on the turnaround section...
Interesting choice.
Oh.
He brings a rim with him. After some banging... and some scraping... and some more scraping...
Freak.
Sly hooks his bumper.
Yikes!
And then he really hooks his bumper.
Yes, man, you made it. Sort of.
And with that, it's time for the slalom.
Here we go. Sly, place your bets.
Instead of holding the wheel properly, Sly steers hand over hand and misses the fourth turn.
Oh, freak.
Sly failed every aspect of this challenge.
I tried to reverse, and I'm just not good at reversing.
This came off going forward.
What?
It's Michael's turn to drive our flagship vehicle.
You know, I was hoping I might get to drive the flagship vehicle once before it got mangled.
In the reversing section, Michael hits...
Three
obstacles, but that's it. But... in the turnaround section, Michael gets stuck.
I am completely wedged.
On the slalom course, Michael starts with a heavy foot, and then he adds gas, speeding up to 80.
Whoa.
Michael might be Canada's worst driver ever.
How in the world did I lose control and traction so completely at only 50? I honestly don't know.
Shelby reverses to the first turn without hitting anything.
Readjusting.
But just getting himself pointed towards the turnaround section...
Oops.
...has taken Shelby 15 minutes.
If you want to cook a pork shoulder in one of those slow cookers, just put it in there, ask Shelby to drive up 10 feet. When he makes it the 10 feet, the pork shoulder will just be falling off the bone.
24 minutes later, I'm wishing I had a piece of pork.
Just figure while we're here, we may as well have a little picnic. But basically, this car is like a table these days, so get stuff out. Dude, what's up? Why aren't you driving the car?
I'm still not comfortable getting to tight spaces, Andrew.
Well, there's Shelby's assessment for turning around in tight spaces. Man can't do it. Come on through here, Shelby. Come on through here. Come on, this week. There you go.
On the 50K an hour slalom, Shelby doesn't have enough time to dilly-dally. And he doesn't have enough time to steer.
Oh.
Even Shelby realizes he could be here till the bitter end.
I believe I might just be in the running for Canada's worst driver ever.
The final driver to reassess is Shirley.
Can you see in the mirror?
Yeah.
Okay.
Shirley can see in the mirror, but only when she's looking at it.
Oh, can't do it.
Shirley doesn't give up, though, and in the turnaround section, she steers her way through flawlessly.
Just about out, Janice.
Doing a lot better than last time I saw her.
However, on the slalom part of our assessment, Shirley's steering is deeply flawed. Shirley has family at home counting on her, which is why she's been trying so hard.
I just don't like disappointing anybody.
When we come back...
Not a crud.
Canada's worst drivers ever come face-to-face with our experts.
Are you Canada's worst driver ever?
On this opening episode of Canada's Worst Driver Ever, we reassess the nominee's skill level. Now it's time to hear what they have to say for themselves. Starting with Michael, who has asked us to show him the footage of himself losing control on our 50K an hour slalom.
Yes, and I also asked for Monsieur Letourneau's feedback on what I might have done wrong.
What Michael did wrong was stare at the object he was trying to avoid.
Oh! When you hit like right in the middle of the front of the car, so it tells me that you're definitely not looking where you want to go, but where the car was going.
Looking forward, yep, looking to the side, as is right, and crud. Yeah, looking pretty much straight ahead at that point. Yeah, definitely. Very, very definitely.
Someone else who looks where they're going instead of where they want to go is Sly.
Why would you come back to something called Canada's worst driver ever?
Well, I still have lots to learn.
What we're learning about Henrietta is that she doesn't really drive anymore.
So sometimes would you not drive in a month?
Yeah, sometimes. Yeah, quite often.
Shelby drives every day, but...
You're worried that you might be Canada's worst driver ever.
Yes.
I just think that compared to some people here, like Angelina, you're gonna do fine.
Okay. I thought you guys made her up. I thought that was a camera trick.
I know. And then she's real, hey?
Angelina's no camera trick.
Angelina is real. And she's just like the rest of the folks in our rehab center.
Are you Canada's worst driver ever?
No,
I am not.
I'm not.
No, I'm definitely not Canada's worst driver ever.
It's time to decide who will be the first Canada's worst driver ever nominee to graduate and go home.
Who's it gonna be, Tim?
Chris.
Shamla?
I'm gonna go with Chris. Yeah, I think he's definitely, in terms of all the drivers that we have here, he's the most skilled.
Most skilled, most confident.
Well, I think Chris is obvious, but I think to stay focused,
we should actually let Henrietta go, and I'll tell you why. I don't think she's really a driver anymore. Andy's retired, Andy's doing the driving, and I think we need to focus on the worst of the worst. I don't think she should graduate, but I think it's time we moved her on.
Disqualifying someone is not something we've ever done, but I tend to agree with you. I don't think she's a driver in our definition of what a driver is. Philippe?
Well, I was gonna say Chris, but you know what? I like your point of view.
Well, this is a special episode too. Like we've got to really focus here on the worst driver ever.
Ever, yeah.
Well, I see your point with Henrietta for the amount of driving that she's doing, but I still stick with Chris.
There's nothing that says we have to graduate people. We don't have to do anything. We can do what's right.
Well, so I think what's right is to graduate Chris.
That's two votes to graduate Chris and two to disqualify Henrietta.
Here at the Driver Rehabilitation Center, we usually graduate someone at the end of every episode. But this year, it's not going to work like that. Henrietta?
Yes.
You're not Canada's worst driver ever. But you're also not a graduate of the rehab center. I am, though, going to give you your driver's license back.
Okay.
And tell you you're free to go.
Oh, thank you, Randall.
No problem. First to leave this year.
Good stuff. Thank you.
Cheers.
Thank you.
I did not expect that.
I did not expect to learn that Henrietta doesn't drive. When we visited her a few weeks ago in PEI, she failed to mention that she drives less than 100 kilometers a year.
I wouldn't walk across the road in front of me.
And for the rest of her life, Henrietta plans on driving even less.
For the most of it, Andy will do all the driving, and I'll just sit in the passenger side and enjoy it.
See you later, Henrietta. Take care. Usually that would be the end of an episode, but not this time. There is one person amongst you who has demonstrated enough skill to be our first graduates. And that person is Canada's worst driver, season one, Chris Ferguson. Way to go, sir. You're not Canada's worst driver ever.
I don't think so.
When we met Chris 8 years ago, he really was Canada's worst driver.
I think I pissed myself.
But now he's shown us beyond a shadow of a doubt that he deserves to graduate from our rehabilitation center.
I'm the number one graduate, and I'm bringing sexy back behind the wheel.
Congratulations, Chris. Will anyone graduate next episode? Or in any of this season's future episodes? Or will there be a seven-way tie for Canada's worst driver ever?
Of those 64 folks, 9 were so bad behind the wheel, they never learned enough to graduate from our educational facility. And it's these 9 people that you've been demanding to see again. So, crud!
This year at the rehab center, we're bringing back the 9 most appalling drivers we have ever had to see which one of them is the most dangerous. And we're calling this extraordinary experiment Canada's worst driver ever.
Do you remember these folks? I do. In fact, these people haunt my dreams because...
One of those 9 people is Canada's worst driver ever.
Is it Chris? Canada's worst driver from season 1?
Son of a motherless goat.
Is it Henrietta? Canada's worst driver from season 2?
I want to quit this.
Maybe Canada's worst driver ever is Michael from Season 2.
Wrong? What are you here?
Many people believe Shelby from Season 3 is Canada's worst driver ever.
I am having issues with vehicle control.
But if you ask me, Angelina from Season 5 should get the unwanted title.
There's no wheel! I don't even think there's a ramp!
Then, of course, there's Dale from Season 6.
I just learned how to text!
And Shirley from Season 7.
Damn it.
And Sly from Season 7. And again, perhaps Kevin, Canada's worst driver from Season 8, is in fact Canada's worst driver ever. The identity of Canada's worst driver ever will be revealed 8 episodes from now.
Oh, my God.
In order for our experts to decide who most deserves that unwanted title, the 9 nominees will be at our Driver Rehabilitation Center getting thoroughly tested on a series of 22 driving challenges.
That was scary.
Will any of these folks find redemption as a graduate of our rehab center? And more importantly, which one of them will end up with the embarrassing title, Canada's Worst Driver Ever?
This is so depressing!
Before your rehabilitation can start, you're gonna have to get yourself to the rehab center. And to do that, you just need to follow the directions that are in these envelopes.
This year, the Driver Rehabilitation Center is located, once again, in the Dunnville, Ontario Airport. And to get there from where they are now should take the bad drivers a little over an hour. They'll have to go along a highway, through a tunnel, and across some train tracks. And Michael will be the first to go.
It's you, buddy. Let's get out of here.
When we met Michael in West Vancouver 7 years ago, he was nominated as Canada's worst driver by his best friend, Eric, who was especially concerned for Michael's safety.
Michael.
Whenever Michael had to drive through a tunnel.
Michael.
That's because in tunnels, Michael had a dizzying habit.
Okay.
When I go through a tunnel, I have to hold my breath because I can't convince myself to breathe.
Eric won't be with Michael when he gets to rehab this year. Eric's having a little bit of a health problem. So, Michael will be driving with Yolanda, his friend Eric's wife.
He was almost killed in a car accident back in March.
He was almost killed?
Yes.
Wait. You were almost killed in a car accident?
I was entirely unharmed in an accident.
That was your fault?
Yes, it was.
Michael fell asleep at the wheel while driving 100K an hour.
My car skipped off a culvert, across the ditch, and through the brush on the other side, so I came to a relatively gradual stop.
Were you going to be Canada's worst driver ever?
I sincerely hope not to be.
See you, Michael. Drive really, really safe. And so begins another year of Canada's worst driver.
En route to rehab.
That was kind of sort of going through a stop sign.
Yolanda's negativity isn't helping Michael.
Don't kill me, my kids need a mother.
Oh, you do such wonders for my confidence.
The next Canada's Worst Driver Ever nominee to hit the road to rehab will be Dale.
All right, Dale, let's go.
Okay.
When we met Dale in St. Catharines, Ontario 3 years ago, she had a dubious honor.
You know there's a stop sign there?
Yeah.
Dale had been nominated as Canada's Worst Driver by more people than any other candidate ever.
My name is John.
Linda.
Trevor.
Sam.
Amanda.
Greg. And I nominated my neighbor Dale as Canada's worst driver.
Dale says she's improved since those days.
What's that mean? Is somebody playing football?
But when we caught up with her just a few weeks ago...
200 milliliters.
That's 200 meters.
Oh, meters.
It all felt eerily familiar.
My name is Liz. Amanda.
Chris.
Greg.
John.
Danny. And I've nominated my Aunt Dale as Canada's worst driver.
Are you a good enough driver now that your family drives with you?
My family doesn't drive with me.
They refuse?
Yeah.
Danny has agreed to drive with Dale just for her rehab experience.
Why are you stopping on a green light?
Oh, I don't know.
Back at the junkyard.
Shelby, you ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's make it happen, my friend.
My favorite driving student ever.
Hop on in, Shelby.
All right.
Will be the next to leave. When we met Shelby 6 years ago in Calgary,
I drive like a grandpa.
He was too afraid to drive the speed limit.
I don't want to go 50.
En route to rehab today.
Slow it back down to 80, please.
Shelby's brother, Ellerick, is wishing Shelby's slowpoke tendencies would return.
Dude, it's a 50 zone. You're doing 70.
Back at the junkyard.
Let's get out of here, Henrietta.
Henrietta will be the next Canada's Worst Driver to hit the road.
Since being at the rehab center, any accidents?
No, none.
No?
No.
Why is that?
Because I don't drive. He does all the driving for me.
He is Andy, Henrietta's husband.
So is this like a life sentence for you, Andy, or what?
It is.
It's a life sentence.
It is a life sentence, yes.
When we first met this Maritimer, she often didn't see things as obvious as yellow center lines.
Andrew, I want to quit this.
These days, the only thing that seems different about Henrietta is her hair color.
Oh. Just went 2 steps on it.
When we come back.
Stop.
The rest of Canada's worst drivers ever hit the road to rehab.
Watch out. Truck.
What? Truck. Oh, that truck.
Four nominees for the unwanted title, Canada's Worst Driver Ever.
What a funny road, look.
It's a tunnel, dude.
Are on the road to rehab.
Michael, breathe. Michael.
The remaining five nominees are still waiting for their turn to leave.
Ready to go and do this?
Sure. Let's go for a road trip.
Sly from season 7 is returning to rehab with Fred, his brother-in-law.
You wouldn't let your kids ride with him when I first met you.
Correct.
And that's still true?
That's still true.
When we met Sly in Lethbridge, Alberta 2 years ago, using his cell phone and eating and drinking while driving was commonplace for him. But after completely losing control in our distracted driving demonstration, Sly made this potentially life-saving promise.
Promise me you'll never eat a sandwich while driving again.
Yeah, I know I won't.
You'll never use your cell phone while driving again.
No.
Now Sly lives in Red Deer, Alberta.
Oh, crap.
And his habit of driving with massive amounts of food and drink in his hands.
See, this is a little easier to eat.
What's easier to eat?
Chicken strip.
Seems to have intensified.
This one time, I was very hungry. Blood sugar was very low. I actually did hit somebody, you know, because I was very hungry.
Driving to our rehab center today.
I'm a slow thinker.
Sly is headed for trouble.
Might have to go through a drive-thru on the way. I'm getting hungry.
Kevin will be the next to leave.
About time.
Kevin was named Canada's worst driver just last year.
You were in a serious accident since leaving the rehab center last time, hey?
The day after season 8 premiered, yes. I came down a little hill, I slid sideways.
And he ended up in the ditch, where he got injuries that include...
whiplash to the upper neck, muscle damage to my lower back, and tailbone injury.
And physically, how are you now?
Physically, I'm about 90%.
Visually, though, this native of McBride, BC, is only 50%.
I'm permanently blind in the right eye.
Having a right eye made of glass is something that deeply concerns Lenny, Kevin's boyfriend.
Watch out, truck.
What?
Truck. Oh, that truck.
Back at the junkyard, Cape Breton's finest will leave next.
I want hugs first. Oh. Show me the money, baby.
Shirley was Canada's worst driver 2 years ago, but she says she's not anymore.
The rehab center totally changed her life.
Totally.
Shirley's daughter, Janice, totally agrees.
Is she going to be Canada's worst driver ever?
Definitely not. Like, she's going to be one of the first graduates.
2 years ago in Halifax, Shirley drove like this.
Am I going over there?
Yes.
Go! Quick! Drive!
And this is Shirley driving in Halifax now.
Oh, Janice, I'm just elated that I can do this.
The secret to Shirley's success is pretty simple.
I was fascinated with the whole thing of learning to become a better driver.
Shirley has been diligently taking extra driving lessons. Headed to our rehab center today. Shirley's still confused in intersections.
Stop. Why did you do that?
I wasn't paying attention.
Only two drivers are left at the junkyard. And one of them doesn't want to drive. Angelina says she's too hungover to take the wheel today.
Hey, I'm all about you not driving. If you don't want to drive, I'm all for that.
I still drive, but I just don't want to drive right now.
Fine.
Stinking of booze on the morning you're supposed to drive yourself to rehab is an outlandishly irresponsible way to start this season. But at least Angelina's acknowledging how dangerous she is.
I like that you're turning a new leaf and you don't want to drive. I think this is a wise choice.
Luckily, Chris has agreed to take her to rehab. Chris was the first ever Canada's worst driver.
How was that for you?
Well, I mean, appropriate for the time, but not anymore.
When we met Chris in season one, he had almost no experience behind the wheel. 8 years later, though, Chris is driving like a veteran.
Oh, right now it's relatively rudimentary.
Today, I'm glad Chris is driving Angelina to rehab. Because in rehab, 4 years ago, Angelina failed more challenges than any student we've ever had.
Oh, my God! That was the worst thing ever!
And on the streets of Sudbury, she spent more time doing her makeup than paying attention to road rules.
I'm a multitasker.
When we visited her there again just a few weeks ago, Angelina's best friend, Christine, told us nothing has changed.
She still is Canada's worst driver. She was then, is now.
Angelina's not just a terror on the roads.
Hey, Mom.
She's a terror in her own garage.
Oh!
When we come back, Canada's worst drivers ever arrive at rehab. The worst drivers we've ever had on our show that's called Canada's Worst Driver are returning to our rehab center to find out which one of them is Canada's worst driver ever.
You could have went.
Last time I did that, I got hit by an 18-wheeler.
And the first to arrive at rehab...
The sign's at rehab center, so it is the rehab center.
...is Shelby. A former slowpoke.
Shelby, baby! Hey, how's it going?
Good, how's it going, Andrew?
Perfect, man.
Hey.
Welcome back to the rehab center.
Nice.
Oh. You know what's gonna happen now, right?
Yeah.
What's gonna happen now?
I have to give you my license.
Mm-hmm. All right, thanks, man. I think you're gonna graduate really fast.
All right.
Perfect.
Okay, thanks.
The next driver to arrive is Michael. Who's illegally wearing Bluetooth earbuds.
The only thing I use them for is answering phone calls.
Why talk on the phone when driving at all?
Well, actually, I just use this to quickly answer. I don't even place calls. I occasionally get them. Hello? Yeah. Oh, shut up. Because sometimes I believe it or not, I have actually received junk phone calls on my cell.
It's a crazy world we live in here in the future.
Yeah.
You know what happens now at this stage of the show.
Oh, yes.
What
happens? I've seen enough.
Thank you very much.
Dale is the next person to approach the rehab center.
I've improved. I have. Not the way I speak, but I've improved.
If Dale has improved, standing on her parking barrier should be safe for me.
Just don't hit it, because I'm standing up. Well, you hit it. Now you... Just pull the park...
Pull the parking
barrier. Dale, stop.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Henrietta has driven almost 100 kilometers today, and that's the longest drive she's done in years.
Do you even want to get that back?
Yes, definitely, in the next 2 days.
I don't think Sly will be graduating in the next 2 days.
How many sides is a stop sign, anyway?
How many sides is a stop sign?
Yes.
For real?
Is that five sides?
On a stop sign.
Stop. Well, it's not. I'm trying to think here.
Of those 64 folks, 9 were so bad behind the wheel, they never learned enough to graduate from our educational facility. And it's these 9 people that you've been demanding to see again. So, crud!
This year at the rehab center, we're bringing back the 9 most appalling drivers we have ever had to see which one of them is the most dangerous. And we're calling this extraordinary experiment Canada's Worst Driver Ever.
Do you remember these folks? I do. In fact, these people haunt my dreams because...
One of those 9 people is Canada's worst driver ever.
Is it Chris? Canada's worst driver from season 1?
Son of a motherless goat.
Is it Henrietta? Canada's worst driver from season 2?
I want to quit this.
Maybe Canada's worst driver ever is Michael from season 2.
Wrong flippin' gear.
Many people believe Shelby from season 3 is Canada's worst driver ever.
I am having issues with vehicle control.
But if you ask me, Angelina from season 5 should get the unwanted title.
There's no wheel! I don't even think there's a ramp!
Then, of course, there's Dale from season 6.
I just learned how to text!
And Shirley from season 7.
Damn it.
And Sly from season 7. Then again, perhaps Kevin, Canada's worst driver from season 8, is in fact Canada's worst driver ever. The identity of Canada's worst driver ever will be revealed 8 episodes from now.
Oh my God.
In order for our experts to decide who most deserves that unwanted title, the 9 nominees will be at our Driver Rehabilitation Center getting thoroughly tested on a series of 22 driving challenges.
That was scary.
Will any of these folks find redemption as a graduate of our rehab center? And more importantly, which one of them will end up with the embarrassing title, Canada's Worst Driver Ever?
This is so depressing!
Before your rehabilitation can start, you're going to have to get yourself to the rehab center. And to do that, you just need to follow the directions that are in these envelopes.
This year, the Driver Rehabilitation Center is located, once again, in the Dunnville, Ontario Airport. And to get there from where they are now should take the bad drivers a little over an hour. They'll have to go along a highway, through a tunnel, and across some train tracks. And Michael will be the first to go.
It's you, buddy. Let's get out of here.
When we met Michael in West Vancouver 7 years ago, he was nominated as Canada's worst driver by his best friend, Eric. who was especially concerned for Michael's safety.
Michael?
Whenever Michael had to drive through a tunnel.
Michael?
That's because in tunnels, Michael had a dizzying habit.
Okay.
When I go through a tunnel, I have to hold my breath because I can't convince myself to breathe.
Eric won't be with Michael when he gets to rehab this year. Eric's having a little bit of a health problem. So, Michael will be driving with Yolanda, his friend Eric's wife.
He was almost killed in the car accident back in March.
He was almost killed?
Yes.
Wait. You were almost killed in a car accident?
I was entirely unharmed in an accident.
That was your fault?
Yes, it was.
Michael fell asleep at the wheel while driving 100 k an hour.
My car skipped off a culvert, across the ditch, and through the brush on the other side, so I came to a relatively gradual stop.
Were you going to be Canada's worst driver ever?
I sincerely hope not to be.
See you, Michael. Drive really, really safe. And so begins another year of Canada's worst driver.
En route to rehab.
That was kind of sort of going through a stop sign.
Yolanda's negativity isn't helping Michael.
Don't kill me, my kids need a mother.
Oh, you do such wonders for my confidence.
The next Canada's Worst Driver Ever nominee to hit the road to rehab will be Dale.
All right, Dale, let's go.
Okay.
When we met Dale in St. Catharines, Ontario, 3 years ago, she had a dubious honor.
You know there's a stop sign there?
Yeah.
Dale had been nominated as Canada's Worst Driver by more people than any other candidate ever.
My name is John.
Linda.
Trevor.
Sam.
Amanda.
Greg. And I nominated my neighbor Dale as Canada's Worst Driver.
Dale says she's improved since those days.
What's that mean? Is somebody still playing football?
But when we caught up with her just a few weeks ago...
200 milliliters.
That's 200 meters.
Oh, meters.
It all felt eerily familiar.
My name is Liz. Amanda.
Chris.
Greg.
John.
Danny. And I've nominated my Aunt Dale as Canada's Worst Driver.
Are you a good enough driver now that your family drives with you?
My family doesn't drive with me.
They refuse?
Yeah.
Danny has agreed to drive with Dale just for her rehab experience.
Why are you stopping on a green light?
Oh, I don't know.
Back at the junkyard.
Shelby, you ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's make it happen, my friend.
My favorite driving student ever.
Hop on in, Shelby.
All right.
Will be the next to leave. When we met Shelby 6 years ago in Calgary.
I drive like a grandpa.
He was too afraid to drive the speed limit.
I don't want to go 50.
En route to rehab today.
Slow it back down to 80, please.
Shelby's brother, Ellerick, is wishing Shelby's slowpoke tendencies would return.
Dude, that's a 50 zone. You're doing 70.
Back at the junkyard.
Let's get out of here, Henrietta.
Henrietta will be the next Canada's Worst Driver to hit the road.
Since being at the rehab center, any accidents?
No, none.
No?
No.
Why is that?
Because I don't drive. He does all the driving for me.
He is Andy, Henrietta's husband.
So is this like a life sentence for you, Andy, or what?
Yes.
It's a life sentence.
It's a life sentence, yes.
When we first met this Maritimer, she often didn't see things as obvious as yellow center lines.
Oh, Andrew, I want to quit this.
These days, the only thing that seems different about Henrietta is her hair color.
Oh, just went through a stop sign.
When we come back.
Stop, stop.
The rest of Canada's worst drivers ever hit the road to rehab.
Watch out. Truck.
What?
Truck.
Oh, that truck.
Four nominees for the unwanted title, Canada's Worst Driver Ever.
What a funny road. Look.
It's a tunnel, dude.
Are on the road to rehab.
Michael, breathe. Michael.
The remaining five nominees are still waiting for their turn to leave.
Ready to go and do this?
Sure. Let's go for a road trip.
Sly from season 7 is returning to rehab with Fred. his brother-in-law.
You wouldn't let your kids ride with him when I first met you.
Correct.
And that's still true?
That's still true.
When we met Sly in Lethbridge, Alberta 2 years ago, using his cell phone and eating and drinking while driving was commonplace for him. But after completely losing control in our distracted driving demonstration, Sly made this potentially life-saving promise.
Promise me you'll never eat a sandwich while driving again.
Yeah, no, I won't.
You'll never use your cell phone while driving again.
No.
Now Sly lives in Red Deer, Alberta.
Oh, crap.
And his habit of driving with massive amounts of food and drink in his hands...
See, this is a little easier to eat.
What's easier to eat?
Chicken strip. Mm.
Seems to have intensified.
This one time, I was very hungry. Blood sugar was very low. I actually did hit somebody, you know, because I was very hungry.
Driving to our rehab center today...
I'm a slow thinker.
Sly is headed for trouble.
Might have to go through a drive-thru on the way. I'm getting hungry.
Kevin will be the next to leave.
About time.
Kevin was named Canada's worst driver just last year.
You were in a serious accident since leaving the rehab center last time, hey?
The day after season 8 premiered, yes. I came down a little hill. I slid sideways.
And he ended up in the ditch, where he got injuries that include...
whiplash to the upper neck, muscle damage to my lower back, and tailbone injury.
And physically, how are you now?
Physically, I'm about 90%.
Visually, though, this native of McBride, BC, is only 50%.
I'm permanently blind in the right eye.
Having a right eye made of glass is something that deeply concerns Lenny, Kevin's boyfriend.
Watch out, truck.
What? Truck. Oh, that truck.
Back at the junkyard, Cape Breton's finest will leave next.
I want hugs first. Oh. Show me the money, baby.
Shirley was Canada's worst driver 2 years ago, but she says she's not anymore.
The rehab center totally changed her life.
Totally.
Shirley's daughter, Janice, totally agrees.
Is she going to be Canada's worst driver ever?
Definitely not. Like, she's going to be one of the first graduates.
2 years ago in Halifax, Shirley drove like this.
Am I going over there?
Yes. Go! Quick! Drive!
And this is Shirley driving in Halifax now.
Oh, Janice, I'm just elated that I can do this.
The secret to Shirley's success is pretty simple.
I was fascinated with the whole thing of learning to become a better driver.
Shirley has been diligently taking extra driving lessons. Headed to our rehab center today. Shirley's still confused in intersections.
Stop, stop. Why did you do that?
I wasn't paying attention.
Only two drivers are left at the junkyard. And one of them doesn't want to drive. Angelina says she's too hungover to take the wheel today.
Hey, I'm all about you not driving. If you don't want to drive, I'm all for that.
Oh, I still drive, but I just don't want to drive right now.
Fine.
Stinking of booze on the morning you're supposed to drive yourself to rehab is an outlandishly irresponsible way to start this season. But at least Angelina's acknowledging how dangerous she is.
I like that you're turning a new leaf and you don't want to drive. I think this is a wise choice.
Luckily, Chris has agreed to take her to rehab. Chris was the first ever Canada's worst driver.
How was that for you?
Well, I mean, appropriate for the time, but not anymore.
When we met Chris in season one, he had almost no experience behind the wheel. 8 years later, though, Chris is driving like a veteran.
Oh, right now it's relatively rudimentary.
Today, I'm glad Chris is driving Angelina to rehab. Because in rehab, 4 years ago, Angelina failed more challenges than any student we've ever had.
Oh my God! That was the worst thing ever!
And on the streets of Sudbury, she spent more time doing her makeup than paying attention to road rules.
I'm a multitasker.
When we visited her there again just a few weeks ago, Angelina's best friend, Christine, told us nothing has changed.
She still is Canada's worst driver. She was then, is now.
Angelina's not just a terror on the roads.
Hey, Mom.
She's a terror in her own garage. When we come back, Canada's worst drivers ever arrive at rehab. The worst drivers we've ever had on our show that's called Canada's Worst Driver are returning to our rehab center to find out which one of them is Canada's worst driver ever.
You could have went.
Last time I did that, I got hit by an 18-wheeler.
And the first to arrive at rehab...
The sign's at rehab center, so it is the rehab center.
...is Shelby. A former slowpoke.
Shelby, baby! Hey, how's it going?
Good, how's it going, Andrew?
Perfect, man.
Hey.
Welcome back to the rehab center.
Nice.
You know what's gonna happen now, right?
Yeah.
What's gonna happen now?
I have to give you my license.
Mm-hmm. All right, thanks, man. I think you're gonna graduate really fast.
All right. Okay,
perfect.
Thanks.
The next driver to arrive is Michael, who's illegally wearing Bluetooth earbuds.
The only thing I use them for is answering phone calls.
Why talk on the phone when driving at all?
Well, actually, I just use this to quickly answer. I don't even place calls. I occasionally get them. Hello? Yeah. Oh, shut up. Just sometimes I believe it or not, I have actually received junk phone calls on my cell.
It's a crazy world we live in here in the future.
Yeah.
You know what happens now at this stage of the show.
Oh, yes.
What happens?
I've seen enough.
Thank you very much.
Dale is the next person to approach the rehab center.
I've improved. I have. Not for my speed, but I've improved.
If Dale has improved, standing on her parking barrier should be safe for me.
Just don't hit it, because I'm standing up. Well, you hit it. Now you... Just pull the park.
Pull the parking brake.
Dale, stop.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Henrietta has driven almost 100 kilometers today. And that's the longest drive she's done in years.
Do you even want to get that back?
Yes, definitely. In the next 2 days.
I don't think Sly will be graduating in the next 2 days.
How many sides is a stop sign, anyway?
How many sides is a stop sign?
Yes.
For real?
Is that 5 sides?
On a stop sign.
Stop. Well, it's not. Wait, I'm trying to think here.
I think Sly should kiss his license goodbye.
I'll say goodbye.
Thank you for this.
Shirley arrives next.
Yay! We're here, Janice!
Which means I am gonna get a hug.
These are fun.
And right behind Shirley...
I notice that you're waving a lot, Kevin.
...is one-eyed Kevin, who this year is bravely putting his license on the line.
If I fail this year in driver rehab, I have vowed to not only turn in my license, but I will also sell my car.
That means...